Anyway, speaking of loving people, apparently we got one more segment here on SmackDown. AJ Styles not loving LA Knight. Because, you know, the whole thing where LA Knight came to his house and attacked him. And I swear to God, I've got a bunch of feedback on the Twitter machine and that also. Cornette, you're being too picky. Y'all know they said they missed what we were saying, many people, Brian. Because we said, yes, it was pre-recorded. They thought I made a joke. I said, now the cops' body cam's not only feeding the City Hall, it's feeding the Fox Network. No, I know it wasn't live on the body cam. Yes, they said it was a few days beforehand or the day before or whatever. Point I was making was it was still shot incredibly well from all sources when it could have been maybe the same thing done, but just shot a little differently. It was my bone of contention with it. And people are like, oh, they didn't listen. They said it was the day before or whatever. But they are reacting now to this. And again, as I appreciate they're making the effort and I see what they're trying to do, and I hate to pick it apart, but this you could see this coming a mile down the road. AJ Styles gets in the ring, do a promo. He's pissed that LA Knight again came to his house, his castle, and attacked him. And the reason why he didn't have him put in jail is so he can expose him as the under-talented piece of trash that he is. And he had asked Aldis to make sure that LA Knight was not here tonight, but he knows that he is. So he basically, AJ dares him to come out. Come on out, LA Knight, wherever I know you're here, come out and show yourself. Which doesn't happen. And then AJ says, well, I bet it could be that this cameraman, and there's the handheld guy in the corner on the apron of the ring, and you see his shot, you see AJ reach out and smack the guy's hat off and snatch him, and the camera goes sideways, and then you see another shot, you realize it's not LA Knight, it's some fucking putz cameraman. But then, as the guy steps out of the ring, suddenly a guy in a hoodie and a face mask or whatever jumps the rail, and there's a couple of security guys coming right over behind him, and they grab him and restrain him, and that's when AJ comes over and pulls the hood off, and it's some nobody that you've never seen before, but the guy was overreacting like he was freaking out on fucking LSD. Like, there was no way that a human being would have... His face, his eyes are bugging out, he's darting back and forth, his fucking movements are peripatetic, and they're struggling, he's not really trying to get away, and he's not trying to say anything, he's just having a fucking spasm. And
what would have happened if he had gotten to AJ? What was he planning on doing this mystery guy? Well, that's the thing.
It was this a plot of LA Knights or whatever? But if so, why was this guy acting like that? Why wasn't he saying something like, please don't hit me, I'm not LA Knight, or anything like that? Or, ha, 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 I gotcha. Or what? No, he acted like he's shocked to be found out that was caught, and you caught me. I didn't get away with whatever the fuck I'm trying to do.
He was acting like the cops had him cornered in an alley.
Yes, he had nowhere to go. They're going to mow him down with the goddamn Tommy guns. But, I mean, I don't know what the fuck was going on. It's like they were shooting him with a cattle prod. So then they drag him out, and now AJ's on the floor, so he turns and keeps promoing into the handheld camera on the floor while the handheld camera has framed AJ and a random crew guy who just happens to be leaning on the announce desk. And at that point, AJ's cutting the promo, and the crew guy takes his hat off, and he takes a wig off, and he takes whatever, and then AJ turns and sees that shot on the video screen and turns around, and LA Knight gets on him and gives him the yeah stomps and chases him out of the arena, and then gets on a desk and cuts a promo, and the people are still with LA Knight when he does something, and when he has a little spotlight like this. AJ is the vessel now that we get our fix of LA Knight in. Could this have been a little more stagey, do you think? How the okay, him being there, he's in disguise, right? I know he's in disguise, so I'm going to just randomly snatch the cameraman. Okay, maybe, but then whoop, the fuck was this guy? And he stays there, and he knows now that people are out to get him, but he's just standing there while this random crew guy is 5 feet to his left, and he doesn't, after he's been frisking everybody else and asking for their social security cards. I'm glad LA Knight cut a promo. That was the highlight of that. And beating AJ up was the highlight of this thing.
I got a kick out of this part of it for the campiness. Again, the guy who jumped the rail was the most ridiculous thing. There's no explanation for any of his behavior or what was going on there. And then LA Knight, it was basic and cheesy, but the crowd reacted to everything as simple as it was. Him taking off the hat. He looked ridiculous in that wig. Him taking off the wig. The place was ready for it. The place has been ready for him. He's been kind of standing in place for a little while just because of everything else happening. But it's nice to see the fans are still really with him. And this was a good segment. And AJ is jacked. You see the shape he's in?
Yes. He's definitely been eating the good old-fashioned Southern cooking down there in Georgia. But I get AJ is so good physically, and it's just with what we're hearing these days with all of these world-class promos with Rock and Roman and Heyman and Cody and fucking Punk and et cetera, that's always been AJ's, you know, not drawback, but it's been the weakest part of his ensemble. But anyway, it finished strong.